Hello guys, and welcome back to a brand new episode of the Hertha Career Mode. Today, to start this episode off, we're going to save, because I've just added a few players to the shortlist, and we're going to go and buy the financial takeover. I don't trust doing it through the right sticks. I've only got one of these, so if we mess it up, that is it. You know, there is no going back. So, I do actually have one at level 65, and we are going to buy it. So now we have a financial takeover, and as long as we load back into the correct career mode, it shouldn't mess up any other ones, which is good. So we now have financial takeover, and if we sim a few days in, it should give us the money, and it's going to be quite healthy. I would have thought, you know, it's definitely healthier than what we've already got. So I'm just going to stop there, just to see if that is already come through or not. By the way, our Champions Cup objective is to reach the group stage, and the Domestic Cup is round of 16. I forgot to show you that in the last episode, so there you go. And we do actually have 55 million, which isn't as much as I was expecting, but it's still a very healthy amount, nevertheless. And I will show you the shortlist. So, we've got Hector Bellerin here, we've got Lovren, Veltman, Tasky, Maximovic, De Vrij, and Marquinhos. For centre-backs. Now, I'm not too sure if I need a centre-back or not, because John Anthony Brooks is doing well. We've got Fabian Schär, who came in for free. So it is difficult to decide whether or not, you know, we need to actually bring in a new centre-back. We will consider that maybe after we've bought other players. We've got Steven Gerrard here, who I want to buy because he's still good. You know, he's still got a really nice set of stats, and he'll probably be alright for two seasons before he, you know, dramatically decreases. So he's someone that, you know, I want to... Oh, he's retiring. Fuck, you know, I didn't realise that, but right, okay, that's off the situation. We've got Nemanja Matic here, who is someone that I really want, but I know he can be expensive, because he is probably one of the best CDMs in the world football. So, yeah, he could be a little bit much. I mean, we'll go in with 15 million, and maybe plus someone else, like Lustenberger, and just see what they say, because I don't want to spend too much on one player, because I do want this money to kind of go well and last. We've got Daily Blind, and we've also got Fabian Delph, i.e. Snake. I'm not an Aston Villa fan, but he is a bit of a snake. We've got Daily Blind here, who is someone that I'd really like to buy, and he'd probably be a little bit cheaper than Matic, and would still do the job very well. So, I mean, if we can maybe get him for £7.5 million, I think he would be an absolutely fantastic signing to bring into the side. I really do like Blind, and he would do us well. We'll get rid of that. Delph, obviously, as well. Balotelli as a striker. I mean, I don't think I'm going to go for Balotelli anymore. You can see the other ones I've got here if you want. Balotelli, obviously, if we need him, I might get him, because he's still decent. You know, he'll probably grow for us as well if we play him enough. I guess Liverpool haven't played him too much. We've got Alvaro Morata, Immobile, Dybala, and Bayern Yang, and Memphis Depay, and Pedro. Now, I do want Depay. That's something that I want to put out there. I really do want Depay. He's really young. I haven't used him this year in career mode for a series anyway. So I would like to, we might offer up just cheekily like £9.5 million, just see what they say to that. And I do also want Immobile and buy a Niang. Now Niang, not necessarily for a starting position in the team, but I know he grows and he is a fantastic player. I've used him once before and he was so freaking good. Like, I have to buy him. He's just so good. So we're going to go in with like £4.5 million for Mbaye Niang. Just see what they say, because we could bring in a lot of players on this money, which is why I don't want to just splash it all. And I do also want Immobile and potentially Dybala. So there's a lot of players we're looking to get, which is exciting. And we'll see how it goes. I mean, Immobile, maybe £12.5 million. I don't know. The problem with Dybala is we've had him before and he didn't grow. So it's a risk bringing in Dybala, but he is good, although we could always bring in Morata over him, who would probably be better if he grows, because that's the worry with Dybala, and I don't want to have to waste money on him. But there we go, we've put in, I think, 6 or 7 bids. We'll come and see what actually happens with them, and then we'll see if we can get any of these players. So the first emails are slowly coming in, and we should have quite a few, because we have sent out about 6 or so bids. I can't imagine any getting accepted. We're going to let John Heitinga go. I've wanted to get rid of him for a long time. He needs to be off the wage bill, that's for sure. Not really any use to me anymore. And we can go and have a look at Ben Hatcher's wages quickly. We're going to sort that out. But this team is going to look a lot different, guys. You know, we're going to be changing it up quite a bit. So we'll see how. I might go and list some players up on the transfer market as well. That's something we need to do. This episode could be a bit longer because there is a lot to get through. So straight away, like, there is quite a few players. Like, we don't really need this guy. I do want to get rid of a lot of the dead wood in this team. So that is something to do. I mean, we'll go by position, actually, because there is quite a few players. Like, Ujar, I don't want him anymore. He was horrendous for us. Wait, that's fine. Vilhena, I might just keep. And, you know, Hegler, I'm not interested in this guy at all. You can go. Ronnie wants to leave anyway. Remember, he said last time, last season even. I'm happy with these guys. Tonelli, I don't want this guy either. Although we only just brought him in. And apart from that, it's just going to be Thomas Kraft as well. So this will raise some extra funds should we need them. And let's continue on. I hope to get one player signed this episode. And maybe one of the bigger guys. You know, Matic is a guy that I want, but I know he's going to be expensive. And we've actually had two offers accepted for Blind and for Mbaye Niang. We sold off Heitinga finally. Dortmund have rejected and Chelsea have rejected. Now, because Man United have accepted, I'm not too worried about the Matic situation because I think we can get around that. You know, I think that won't be a problem now. Daily Blind would be absolutely fine. Completely happy with that. We'll leave it there just in case, but it's going to be a bit too expensive in my opinion. And they've accepted for Niang, who will be a kind of a backup striker, but he can also play on the wing as well. So potentially I could use him as a left winger, depending how much Depay is going to cost. So, you know, Niang would be a really good player. He grows quite well. I mean, I don't know if he'll grow too much for us in the time that we're going to be here. But, you know, we should see. We should have at least, we'll definitely have one more season at Hertha and hopefully another one as well, which will be pretty good. And we'll pump this up to 15.5 million for Immobile. Like, the striker situation is a big thing because I'm going to be playing Kalou as a winger. So it's going to mean, it means you have to buy two new strikers, which is fine. And if we get Niang as well, that'll be a three. So we'll have enough strikers and stuff. 18.5 for Morata. That seems steep. Like, that does seem steep. I don't really want to have to pay 18.5 million for Morata because we've got other positions to fill. And I've got to be careful with this money. So they've rejected. Depay, he could be a little bit of a pain. He could be a little bit of a pain. I mean, I'll probably put in one more bid of 11.5 or 12.5 even. Sorry about that. And just see what they say, if they will go for that or not. But that just seems very steep for Morata. I know he's a good player, but even still, it is quite a lot of money. But we could always offer up Anthony Ujar, maybe plus 2 million. So we had two contract declines and we've had an unacceptable thing. So Immobile seems to be worth quite a lot of cash, which is a shame. So I want to use him this year. So we're going to go in with 17.5 million plus Anthony Ujar. That comes to nearly 22 million, about 21. Niang, I like living there, and you could be persuaded. Really, dude, like, are you taking a piss? We'll go 10% on the goals if he has to. I'm not putting him as an important team player because I don't know what rating he is right now, so it's kind of risky to do that. And he doesn't want to relocate either, which is a shame. So maybe this will persuade him. I mean, he's getting crucial first team action here. Like, Daily Blind will slot straight into the team and he'll be like our main CDM. So I'm surprised that Blind is being so stubborn with that. You know, surely it's better to play first team football week in, week out than not at all. But clearly Daily Blind likes to sit on the bench and make a lot of money by the looks of it. And they've accepted, they've rejected even for Depay. So this is looking tough. Like, even with this amount of money, it's looking like it's not the easiest thing in the world to sign these players, which is a shame. You know, I do want to bring in about 6 to 7 players, so. And it's still getting rejected. Like, this is difficult, dudes. We're not interested. So we're just going to have to cough up, basically. And Immobile is an important part. So I think for him, I don't mind coughing up the money. Just because, you know, 20 million. 20 million pounds. That's a decent offer. And that's a lot of our money gone. You know, it is already. PSV, I just don't think that's going to be an ideal situation. You know, I don't want to just absolutely spunk the money in one go. You know, I just think it would be very stupid of me to do that. But Niang has accepted, so that is one player into the team. He's a younger player, but he'll be a really good player maybe next season or after January, and he should grow quite quickly as well, which would be absolutely sweet. So he is a 71, but he does grow quite nicely, and he'll be our backup striker. So he can fit into the bench, something like that. We'll have to sort this out at some point because it is an absolute mess. But yeah, he should fit in quite nicely. That is our first signing, which is good. And we're not interested. So Morata, again, it just looks like everyone's going to be expensive. Which is a shame. Like, Morata is a bit of a bit expensive. I mean, 17.5 million. That's quite a lot for Morata. But hey, we'll see. I don't know if I want to actually pay that for him. But we do need two strikers, so we've got to think striker is the most important position to fill, along with CDM. We've got an offer for Ujar. I'm just going to accept it. Like, it's extra bit of money there. It saves us having to keep him because he's dog shit. Daily Blind is proving a nightmare, isn't he? So 10% crucial. Come on. I don't want to go too much above 95k because I just think that's a rip off otherwise for Blind. Yeah, this is proving hard. Like, this always happens, even with, you know, when you get a financial takeover, it just proves difficult to actually get people. But they've accepted 20 million, which is still a lot, and I'm not pleased with that. But he's a player we really need, and I'm really, really pleased with the acceptance of the offer. And, I mean, Dybala, I'm still thinking, will be good, but I'm worried he isn't going to grow. That's the only reason I'm not going for him. Because I'm just worried. And Marchetti, that's a decent offer, to be fair, but we want to keep Marchetti. He's been good to us, and I think he should stay. We don't want to completely sell the whole team that we had last season. But obviously, Mbaye Niang just stays on the bench for now until he grows, and he'll be a good backup striker slash right winger. They've accepted for Morata, so potentially we could go Morata and Immobile up front. I don't know. Morata's a sketchy one for me because he is expensive, you know. 17.5 million is quite a lot of money for him. I might just look at Dybala, but we've already used him this year, which does put me off. But this guy as well looks decent. Palaszczuk, I think he grows quite well. Not 100% sure, to be honest, but I mean, you know, it's tough, guys. Like, it's tough to find a player that you're happy with and will grow. Like, he could be a cheaper option, I guess. The reason I want Dybala is because he's a lot younger, which means he'll grow. I mean, so is Morata, in all honesty. I mean, if we scout him, I might be more inclined to sign him. So the reason I'm not signing him right now is just because I don't know. Like, I don't know if I want to spend that much money on him. And that'd be 37 million just on two strikers. So Blind is just proving to be an absolute cunt. Like, this is my final offer for Daily Blind, and if he doesn't accept it, then he's not joining the club, because it is so frustrating, like, trying to get a player to join, and he's cheap, but his contract isn't cheap. That's the thing. Like, we need a CDM, really. Lustenberg is alright, but I feel like we need someone just like, a little bit better than him, and Immobile is the first big signing into the team. That's a lot of money right there. That is scary amount of money, because although he's an 80 rated, we still need one player there. We need Stocker to come back from injury. You know, we need a CDM and we need a left mid at least. Like, we're gonna have to be kind of careful with this money now. I don't want to just spunk it all. You know, we've got to be really, really careful now, because otherwise we could just end up spending too much money. So I think CDM and striker is the position, and I don't know if I want Blind or not. I might go and look for someone else. Morata's declined. That's not too bad, actually, because I don't know if I want Morata. I think he could be a bit of a waste of money. We need to be kind of careful now, because we're kind of running on low income. Like, 25 million won't go far if we just splash it, so we've got to really think about who we want. I know Barami is a really good player to have. Wait, no, he's not. That's the other guy, sorry. Luis Gustavo, Nudstada, Bender. Like, I want one of the Bender brothers. They're both pretty decent. Gary Medel, Xabi Alonso, Polanski, Lahm. Like, Lahm goes for so much. You know, that's the problem there. It is tough. It is generally tough to think. I think the Bender brothers are quite tempting, because they're decent. Like, one of them, Sven Bender. I don't know what his value is, though. That's the thing. I don't think he'd be that cheap. Luis Gustavo. I like Luis Gustavo. I think he's a really good player. He'd be a fantastic. He's 83 rated though, but that would seriously strengthen the team. But again, it is a little bit expensive. We'll see. Gon Alonso. We already used him at Arsenal, so it's kind of like, I wouldn't mind getting Gon Alonso again. You know, he was good at Arsenal, but you know, do I want to use him straight away again? I don't know. And you can see we haven't got that much money. Like, because the wage budget was tight anyway, it's kind of left us a bit dry. Right, so Daily Blind, we cannot get him. I can't get Blind. I'm not paying that much for him. I'm sorry, but he's not worth that much. Like, I'm not paying him 100 grand a week. That is just taking a piss, really. And what I'm going to do is go and have a look on SoFIFA, and then I'll be back. So I'll be like a couple of minutes or so. Actually, no, I won't. Fuck it. I think this will be near the end of the episode, guys. I don't want to do too much because I kind of need to go and have a look at SoFIFA and stuff, kind of get some players down. Because, I mean, who else have we got, striker-wise? Dybala. That's it, like, and he doesn't look like he's actually growing, and Balotelli. So, I think I'm going to go and get some new suggestions, sort out this list of players, and then in the next episode, we'll kind of decide where we're going with it. So anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you have enjoyed. If you have, if we can smash over 5 likes, that'd be absolutely awesome. If you haven't already, go and subscribe to the channel, and I'll speak to you guys in the next episode very soon.